I suppose some introductions are in order.
Must be different starting Hogwarts in your...
Already knew that. Can I help you?
Still at the end of the sorting ceremony.
Ah, you're the new fifth year. I'm Sebastian Sallow. Welcome to Slytherin.
Thank you.
Not everyone has a ministry escort to school.
He was a friend of Professor Figgs who merely joined us for the ride.
Still, impressive. Dreadful way to go, poor fellow. Glad you and Fig are all right.
It was dreadful, certainly, but quite an experience nonetheless.
Interesting perspective. How did you and Fig manage to escape?
It's all still a bit of a blur, to be honest.
Didn't mean to press. You just get yourself settled. We can talk more later.
What book were you reading?
A spell book I picked up. Has a few interesting things, but not exactly what I was looking for. I'm sure you'll find out soon enough. But not every spell you may need can be found in our assigned textbooks.
Are you saying some spells aren't taught at Hogwarts? Which ones?
Seems I may have met a kindred spirit. That is a conversation for another time. It was good meeting you. Good luck today.
I wouldn't do that if I were you. Ugh, not going to move there, are you?
Here, watch this.
Don't say I didn't warn you.
Checkmate.
Told you. They should have listened to me.
Ah, I know who you are. You're the new Slytherin, the one who barged in with Professor Fig last night. Interesting tactic on your first day, taking all the attention away from the first years.
I'm Imelda, by the way. Shame I wasn't with you and Fig. I could have lured that dragon away. My skills in a broom are legendary.
Perhaps Professor Fig's friend would have survived if we'd had your help.
Precisely. Perhaps one of these days I'll show you a thing or two about flying. I can teach you more than Kagawa ever could. Speaking of which, I'd like to get in some time on my broom before classes.
Are you a keen wizard chess fan? You knew that boy was going to lose the match.
Not really. Much too sedate a pastime for me. Also, it's simply not that challenging. The moves are always so obvious. Why does no one else see it?
Do you have a lot of time to fly during school?
I make the time. There's nothing like swerving through the spires of the castle and around the Quidditch pitch to clear the mind.
Goodbye, Imelda.
Nice meeting you.
I think I heard one.
Doubt mermaids find us that interesting.
Ah, based on all the chatter when you entered the common room, I'm guessing you're the new fifth year. I'm Ominous. Ominous Gaunt.
Nice to meet you, Ominous.
Well, you certainly had a memorable arrival.
Well, if I'm going to make my mark here, I had to start right away.
You're definitely in the right house.
Do let me know if I can be of any help as you navigate your first days here, though I doubt you'll need it.
Did that student say he thought he heard a mermaid?
Yes, but I've never heard of a mermaid showing up outside our common room window. It is fun to play along, though. Been known to keep some first years on the lookout for hours.
Were you expecting to be sorted into Slytherin?
Most certainly. My family on my father's side are direct descendants of Salazar Slytherin, one of the four founders of Hogwarts.
Not something I'm especially proud of, mind you. He was obsessed with blood status. A pureblood maniac. Unfortunately, most of his descendants do not fall far from that tree.
Thank you, Ominous. Very nice to meet you.
Pleasure was all mine. Don't be a stranger.
Is the new fifth-year Slytherin in here? Professor Weasley's waiting for you just by the stairs.
I trust you're ready for your first day at Hogwarts?
I've been dreaming of this day for a long time. Can't believe I'm here.
Well, you are here. Make the most of it. You only have one first day at Hogwarts. Now, in light of your unique situation, joining us as a fifth year, you'll need to catch up with your classmates and not fall behind. Especially as you'll be expected to complete your OWLs at the end of the year.
OWLs? Owls.
Yes, your ordinary wizarding level exams. They will determine what type of career you can have when you leave here. After much discussion with the headmaster and the Department of Magical Education at the Ministry, we've devised something extraordinary to ensure your success. Here you are.
What is it?
It is a wizard's field guide. It will help you to keep track of what you are learning so that you master all that's expected of a fifth year. You would be wise to take full advantage of this exceptionally valuable resource.
Thank you, Professor, but what do you mean it will keep track of what I'm learning?
Perhaps seeing it in action will answer any questions you may have. Walk with me and we shall put it to the test. This way.
Do you think it's painful to be in a half-transition?
I certainly would have appreciated something like the field guide when I was a student. Using the guide will also train you to be alert to your surroundings. The guide will give you opportunities to practice your magic and educate yourself about wizarding lore. Do keep up. Why don't you cast Revelio on that statue and see what details the field guide can provide?
Lumos.
Really mastered that one, haven't you?
Revelio.
clever, isn't it? Keep your eyes open for more opportunities like that, inside and outside of the castle. Timing. Perfect opportunity to show you how to use flu flames to get around a bit quicker. Your field guide contains a map of the castle. Open it up and find Central Hall. And here we are, quite the time saver. These stairs lead directly to Central Hall. You can get almost anywhere in the castle quickly from Central Hall. Always something happening here. It's the heart of the hive, our King's Cross station, so to speak. That should be all for now. You'll be expected to attend both Charms and Defense Against the Dark Arts classes today. And I'd like to be sure you get to Hogsmeade as soon as possible to replace the supplies you lost on the way here.
What will I learn in Charms class?
Exactly what you might expect. Spells, charms, jinxes, all terribly useful. I think you will enjoy Professor Ronan. He's a clever and entertaining wizard, and a talented teacher.
Can you tell me more about the Defense Against the Dark Arts class?
Defense Against the Dark Arts, as the name implies, focuses on how to defend oneself against the evils that lurk beyond these walls. A mastery of Defense Against the Dark Arts is required for those who aspire to become aurors. Fortunately, we are lucky to have the ever-gifted Professor Hecate in charge of our students' education in that regard.
You mentioned Hogsmeade, Professor.
Hogsmeade is the only all-wizarding village in Britain and is home to an array of shops and pubs. You should be able to find all of the school supplies you require in Hogsmeade. You will also, I imagine, enjoy many a butterbeer there with friends in due course.
Thank you, Professor Weasley.
A lot to absorb on your first day, and you have much to learn. Happily, your professors have agreed to create additional assignments for you outside of class. You'll be up to speed in no time. Judging by your adept use of Revelio earlier, I'd say Professor Fig succeeded in at least showing you the basics.
He did, Professor.
He's been terribly vague as to the events preceding your arrival, specifically about what happened after that awful dragon attack. My suspicion is that there's more to the story than a search for belongings and an extended trip up to the castle.
We did take a bit of a detour on the way here. Ended up exploring some ruins and... I shouldn't say more.
Exploring ruins? Well, I presume Professor Fig has his reasons for keeping the details to himself for now. Speak of the devil, Professor Fig. Your ears must have been burning.
Oh?
Yes. You seem to have provided our new fifth year with a solid foundation in the basics of spellcasting.
Ah, I'm afraid I can't take all the credit there, Professor. They've a rare aptitude for magic, it seems.
Hmm. Well, I'm just glad you both arrived in one piece. Perfectly good boats and carriages to Hogwarts, and you chose to fly in the path of a dragon.
I wouldn't say I chose the dragon's path, Professor. Rather unfortunately, it would seem that it chose us.
Very well. Enough chit-chat. I need to get to class myself. Might I rely on you, Professor Fig, to explain the details of the field guide's map?
Of course.
Thank you. Good luck today. And remember to use your field guide. It will be invaluable to you. And invaluable to me, as I'll be using it to keep up to date on your progress.
Yes, Professor.
Come and find me in my classroom after you've attended both classes today, and I'll explain more about those assignments I mentioned. And we'll see if we can't get you to Hogsmeade for those supplies.
It's good to see you, Professor.
And you. I was hoping our paths would cross today, before you immersed yourself in studies. Did I hear you and Professor Weasley talking about exploring ruins?
She caught me off guard. I didn't tell her anything else about our travels here. I will say, I think she suspects we're not being entirely forthcoming.
Yes, well, Professor Weasley is a brilliant and astute witch. It was right to keep the details to yourself for now. We don't know where this path we've embarked upon will lead. It may require a bit more flexibility with your time than she would approve of. And she may feel obliged to share details with the headmaster that would be better left between us.
Understood, Professor.
Good. Now, as capable as you are, I believe the ability you possess obliges you to be well-trained. Happily, you have the benefit of an exceptionally skilled team of witches and wizards to guide you. Speaking of guides, and so that I may avoid another not-so-subtle reproof from Professor Weasley, why don't I show you the clever enchantment we included in the field guide's map? Unfold it and have a look. The map is enchanted to help you find your way.
This will be incredibly helpful. Thank you.
Now, sounds like you've quite a day ahead, what with classes and a trip to Hogsmeade for supplies, including your own wand. You'll enjoy Mr. Ollivander. He's an exceptional craftsman and a good friend. I shall reach out when I have more information about our mysterious locket. For now, focus on your classes and pay attention. More than your owls may hinge on the magic you are able to master within these walls.
Good enough to blast each other to pieces on your own time. I get new students every year, but I only have one Hebridean black skull. It was a token from the Great Poacher Raid of 1878. No doubt you've heard of it. Now, you may be asking yourself how an old woman like me single-handedly took out the largest poacher ring in eastern Wales and lived to boast about it. Knowledge. To the wise, age matters very little. Today we will review a spell that has saved me from death at the hands of dark wizards more times than I care to remember. Levioso.
Levioso? A levitation charm?
Levioso! A surprised opponent is a weak opponent. Care to defend yourself, Master Pruitt? No? One thing I've learned as an unspeakable is the value of simplicity, especially in the heat of battle. Now, let's practice what we've just learned, starting with something small.
Levioso!
Now, let's try something a little larger. Let us begin with a basic cast. Dummy deflected your cast. This time, cast Levioso first, then the basic cast. Remember, a surprised opponent is a weak opponent.
Levioso.
Good. Now, the basic cast. Well done. Very good. But the best way to practice is by dueling. We'll start with you two. Duelist, take your marks.
Time for a proper Hogwarts welcome.
Now, I want a fair duel, using only Levioso, basic cast, and Protego. You may begin.
Levioso!
Lucky.
Nothing lucky about it. This can't be your first duel. Let's just say I'm a quick learner. Levioso!
Complicates things. Not bad for a beginner. You give as good as you get.
I put you on the spot, and you rose to the challenge. Points to Slytherin.
Thank you, Professor Hecate. Glad to have the opportunity to practice.
If what I've seen today is any indication, we can expect great things from you. I demand excellence from my students. They are capable of achieving it, and they must achieve it. A classroom duel is one thing, but battling dark wizards, or as ever more likely, goblins, is a different kettle of Grindelows entirely.
Understood, Professor.
So, I'd advise you to keep practicing whenever you can. Perhaps Mr. Sallow will have some ideas for you. Again, well done today. I shall reach out soon with additional assignments. All right, that's enough spectacle for one day. Class is dismissed.
Nice work.
I enjoyed that.
Well, that duel was quite something. Everyone will be talking about it.
It was certainly good practice.
Practice? Felt more like I was dueling an expert. Didn't expect a new student to be so deft with a wand. Then again, perhaps this wasn't your first duel.
I've dueled enough. Consider yourself lucky I held back.
Huh, fair enough. You owe me an honest duel when you aren't. You know, You might be a perfect fit for a certain exclusive, unsanctioned dueling organization.
Exclusive and unsanctioned. Count me in.
Excellent. Knew I was right about you. If you want to get the most out of your time at Hogwarts, you're going to need to break the rules now and then. Whether it's joining a secret dueling club, or sneaking into the restricted section of the library, you just have to be clever enough not to get caught.
Thank you, Sebastian. I'll keep that in mind.
Good. Pleasure chatting with you. I'm sure I'll see you soon. Perhaps somewhere unsanctioned? We'll see if your performance today was sheer luck or actual skill. Look for Luke and Brattleby near the clock tower entrance, if you're interested. Till next time.
Professor Ronan tends to go on a bit. We sometimes have to remind him to finish the lesson.
Here, behind you, there is an open seat here.
Thank you.
Hello, I am Nettie. So you are the new student. Have you met Professor Ronan yet?
Shall we begin? Welcome to year 5 of Charmed. Now, this will be a crucial year in your education on the art of charm work, but I am confident that we will take hold with a passion and rigor requisite of such a challenge. Right, now, everyone, please open your textbooks to page 517. But before we begin, can anyone here tell me the difference between the incantations of the color change and growth charms? Anyone? Anyone? I am afraid it is too late to study now. My, the summer months must have really taken a toll on you all. By the looks of it, you all spent your holidays practicing Obliviate on one another. Do you even remember how to perform a basic summoning charm? Well, it seems that we are in dire need of review. Everyone get into pairs and take positions on opposite sides of the classroom. Now let's put those textbooks to use as the blunt objects you so believe they are and take turns summoning them out of one another's hands. Only one book will be needed per partnership, Miss Dale. Thank you. Get into place now.
Akio.
That is not bad.
You are a swift learner. I see a lot of potential, but remember, potential is nothing without practice. Keep at it. You might just rival Miss Onai here. Very good, everyone. That's enough of that. Well, as you all seem to have the basics down, and it is an exceptionally lovely day, I was thinking that we might have ourselves a little excursion outside for a spot of fresh air. After me. Ah, I've always found that fun goes hand in hand with mastery, as I'm sure the Quidditch players amongst us would agree, So, what better than a bit of sport to put our prowess with the summoning charm to the test, right? So why don't we have our newest student start us off? Very simply, cast Accio on one of the spheres and relinquish your charm at the last possible moment. Now, think of this like gobstones, if you will. But instead of throwing the marbles out, you are summoning them toward you. The trick is to pull the sphere as far as possible, but not a bit more, or it'll fall, yes? Now, I could keep talking about theory all day, but practice is the best professor. Show us how it's done. Accio! Splendid! Very good! Stay focused! Excellent control there! Very good! Points to Slytherin! But there's certainly no sport in playing without some friendly competition. Miss Onai, would you care to give our new student a bit of a challenge? Come on up. You'll be the blues, just as before, and Miss Onai, you are playing red. Clear?
Yes, sir.
What's this?
Don't lose your composure.
Let us do this.
Make this a bit more interesting, shall we?
I think we are well past interesting at this point.
I'll say.
Enough chatter. Focus now. You will need it. This round settles it all.
Here we go!
Not to worry.
Let us see this. That is how it's done.
Very good, both of you. Well done.
Class is dismissed. Gather your things on the way out.
Well done back there. You took the loss in stride. Didn't want to go too easy on you. Took me weeks to become proficient with Accio. Took weeks for me to get anything right when I transferred here. It gets easier, I promise.
Thank you, but I've been holding my own.
I appreciate your confidence. I transferred here from Ouagadougou just before my fourth year. My mother received an offer to teach divination here. Before I knew it, we had left Uganda and were halfway around the world at a new school in a new country.
Is Ouagadougou much bigger than Hogwarts?
Ouagadougou School of Magic is the largest wizarding school in the world. So yes, bigger than Hogwarts. But it never seemed intimidating or overwhelming to me. It always felt like home.
Is Ouagadougou a castle, like Hogwarts?
Its address is Mountains of the Moon. It is not so much a castle as a beautiful edifice carved out of the mountainside. I remember the first time I saw it, the mist was so thick I could hardly make out anything at all. And then it just materialized before me, this enormous school that seemed to be floating in midair.
This may seem an odd question, but is magic the same there as it is here?
Mostly, yes. But I did have to learn how to use a wand when I arrived here. Hardly anyone at Ouagadougou uses one.
You can cast spells without a wand?
Oh, yes. I find wandless magic to be much more instinctive. Not to mention quite convenient if one is without their wand. I must admit, however, that I am growing quite fond of using a wand. It seems very dramatic.
It's nice to learn about another wizarding school.
Thank you for asking. I do miss Ouagadougou, but I am glad to be here at Hogwarts. Ah, I think Professor Ronan wants to talk to you. Better not keep him waiting. Until next time.
Of course. You can use Accio on
humans. A word, if you would.
If you're so inclined.
Well, you'd be using it on clothing, to be precise, Sebastian. You know it won't work on humans.
You wanted to speak with me, Professor?
I did. I trust your first charms lesson lived up to expectation?
Well, an outdoor competition wasn't exactly the lesson I was expecting, sir.
What charm is there in the expected? Miss Onai is a talented witch. Take it in stride. One often gains the most from the battles one has lost.
Of course, Professor. It was a challenging match.
Miss Onai is always a fierce competitor, though I sense that she is a bit distracted of late. Now, Professor Weasley has asked that your professors give you instruction outside of the ordinary curriculum. Expect to hear from me soon regarding a special assignment that I am preparing for you.
What about the room, Professor?
I was thinking the same thing, Deke. Perhaps you could help.
Oh, excuse, Deke.
Ah, there you are. I trust your first classes went well?
They did, Professor.
I heard as much from Professors Hecate and Ronan. Seems Professor Fig taught you quite a bit during your brief detour near... what was it you said? Some ruins? I'd wager there's a good deal more to your travels here than what you've told me. Isn't there?
Nothing more, Professor.
I see. Like trying to get a sonnet from a streeler. Regardless, you must continue to build upon what you've learned. In that regard, I've asked your professors to help hasten your progress with some extra assignments.
Professor Ronan did mention something about that.
In fact, Professor Ronan will meet you outside momentarily to assign your first one. Now, regarding the trip to Hogsmeade I mentioned earlier, we've arranged to replace the supplies lost on your way here, including seeds, potion recipes, and spellcrafts.
Thank you, Professor.
And Mr. Ollivander will connect you with the perfect wand. You've managed your classes well with a borrowed wand, but you'll find the magic you cast with your own wand to be far superior.
Can you tell me more about the potions shop, Professor?
J. Pippin's Potions stocks a wide array of potions ingredients, although they rarely sell recipes. Professor Sharp asked that they have a couple of particular recipes on hand for you.
I've never heard of a spellcraft before, Professor. What is it?
A spellcraft is a recipe of sorts used when conjuring objects. I shall explain more about them when you begin working with transfiguration magic.
There's an Ollivander's in Hogsmeade.
There is. Most people are familiar with the shop in Diagon Alley. We're fortunate to have someone like him nearby. Mr. Ollivander is a genuine craftsman and highly skilled wand maker. I would trust no one else to pair me with a wand.
I'm eager to get to Hogsmeade.
Very well. I'd like you to make your first visit to the village with a classmate. Help you get your bearings. Perhaps Sebastian Sallow or Natsai Oni. I've noticed you spending time with them.
I'd like to go with Sebastian.
Glad to hear it. Mr. Sallow is a capable young wizard, and he knows the area. He'll keep you well clear of any of Victor Rookwood's undesirables en route.
Rookwood?
A rather unsavory local. Best to avoid him and his associates, including his right hand of sorts, Theophilus Harlow, if you can. Once you've finished Professor Ronan's assignment, your friend will meet you at the castle doors. No time to waste. The sooner you complete your work, the sooner you can enjoy a butterbeer at the Three Broomsticks.
There you are.
You have a new spell to teach me, Professor.
Indeed I do, and an exceedingly useful one at that, the mending charm, Reparo. Fixes things right up, makes a broken object good as new in the blink of an eye.
It seems as if that might come in handy.
More frequently than one would imagine. As Professor Weasley mentioned, I am not the only one who will be teaching you spells outside of class in an effort to catch you up with your peers. A number of your professors have agreed to do so as well, but first, each shall ask that you complete a few preliminary tasks to hone your magic. I have arranged some for today. See them through and then report back to me. We will have you casting Reparo in no time.
Why must I first complete tasks to learn Reparo?
No lesson or lecture can compare to first-hand experience, and these tasks should provide you with just that. Such experience is invaluable when mastering any new bit of magic.
I'll start on the task right away, Professor. This is the right area. I wonder where the flying page is.
Revelio.
Flying page must be around here somewhere.
Some kind soul help me.
Brilliant.
I trust the preliminary tasks weren't too...
I completed the assignments, Professor.
Marvelous. You clearly know your way around basic charms. Let us give the old mending charm a try then, shall we? Remember to be deliberate in your enunciation and movements. I want to see some vigor. Now, wand at the ready.
Yes, sir.
Remember, your wand is a conduit of your magic. That's it. Very good. If you would like to practice mending something, have a go with that broken statue in the alcove by the water. It allegedly symbolized heartbreak. Perhaps a jilted lover thought it too accurate and lashed out.
Repair.
Nicely done. Works like a charm, doesn't it?
Thank you.